If you need a friend.
Macam mana kita nak mewujudkan sesuatu perkara itu tanpa ilmu? Okay, sebagai contoh, kalau kamu tak tahu macam mana nak buat meja, macam mana kamu nak buat meja?
Pendidikan ini, okay, dia merupakan asas pembentukan negara manusia yang bersatu.
Oh, boleh.
Suara cikgu jelas kan?
Jelas. Ya, jelas cikgu.
And we are actually very curious about English teacher.
Cikgu sudah botak kok tengah. Semalam cikgu gunting sendiri saja. Cikgu takut pergi kedai. Jawapan dia pun cikgu pun tak tahu.
Orang yang menjadi inspirasi kepada girl yang menjaga saya sejak ayah saya meninggal pada usia saya 5 tahun.
Cikgu sangat suka generasi muda.
Teacher is always be my very first choice ambition since I was young.
Saya rasa pekerjaan guru ini adalah satu saluran saya lebih mendekat kepada generasi yang baru.
Mereka ni, kalau kita jaga betul-betul, kalau kita terap betul-betul, kalau kita bimbing betul-betul, mereka akan menjadi manusia yang sangat, orang panggil cemerlang, sangat hebatlah.
Jika saya mau orang-orang yang seperti saya, di zaman yang lain, mengalami perubahan di dalam cara pandang mereka terhadap masalah kehidupan yang mereka alami. So, itu mengapa saya bidang pendidikan ataupun menjadi guru.
Proses mengali ilmu itu, kemudian proses menyampaikan ilmu itu, dan juga konsep pendidikan itu sendiri yang sebenarnya mampu menjadikan cikgu itu menjadi insan yang lebih baik, lebih matang. Dan ini yang menarik minat cikgu lah sebenarnya untuk jadi seorang warga pendidik. Do you really
wanna live forever? Enter university, I found that I feel like I want to give up teaching, because I get to see the burden and the difficulties of becoming a teacher during my years, whereby you need to go through a lot of interviews, exams, tests, so on. And you have to get ready to prepare yourself, being posted to rural areas whereby you cannot get together with your family. So during university, I started to change my ambition to be a tour guide. I don't want to perish like a fading
horse. Youth like dying. Ya, satu case, yaitu tahun ke-6, ke-7, cikgu mengajar. Cikgu ada mengajar seorang pelajar yang malas buat kerja rumah, kena tegur, melawan balik. Dan sampai satu ketika, dia ni adalah jiran saya. Dan satu malam, dia pergi lontar saya dengan... Saya memaafkan dia. I wanna be forever young.
Do you really wanna live forever? Kalau cikgu give up, cikgu akan rasa lebih berat.
Bila saya melihat kejayaan pelajar, macam satu kegembiraan, bukan kerana saya berjaya. Saya melihat bahawa mereka sudah berubah cara pandang mereka, masalah yang mereka hadapi masa mereka usia muda, dan mereka berjaya menemukan jalan untuk menghadapi masalah.
Cikgu percaya tidak ada manusia yang tidak pandai, ya. Semua manusia pandai, tetapi aspek pandai dia berbeza. Jadi itulah tugas cikgu. Cikgu kena pasti seorang-seorang aspek pandai dia di mana, dan kita kena asahkan jadi bintang, jadi bercahaya.
My patience in teaching English now is because I want to inspire, to motivate more students, to let them realize that the importance of English.
Semakin banyak anak-anak kidurung nanti boleh terlibat dalam inovasi, misi kemanusiaan, boleh terlibat dalam cara membantu orang-orang lain lah. Cikgu nak anak-anak kidurung ini pandai berdikari,
belajar di dalam akademik saja, tetapi karakter yang lebih diubahkan. Nah, perubahan karakter membawa kepada perubahan akademik juga.
Cikgu selalu pesan, mesti sayang ibu bapa, mesti sayang mak, mesti sayang ayah. Sebab pengguna banyak EO, betul? Saya nak kira orang lebih cemerlang, bukan saja dalam bidang sukan, bukan saja bagian akademik, tapi aspek kemanusiaan itu sendiri. Kasih sayang.
Just keep improving myself because I still think that I still have like a long way to learn. Watching I keep waiting. This year is the 6 years of my teaching year, so I found that I need to go for more. Not only like just doing, you know, just working in school, teaching, and then that's it. So what I'm doing now is I further my studies in master. So I hope that after I graduate from master, I can go for more, and maybe I can get innovate some creative and new teaching methods that will be able to cater more students' learning needs in class. Study for more, improve myself, and to be a better one.
Take my breath away.
I actually didn't think about being a teacher. I've always wanted to become a doctor when I was in secondary school. But because I couldn't secure full scholarship to study medicine, and I was just thinking, what else do I want to do to serve the community? Yeah, so that is when I start to think about maybe I can become a teacher. And then because I really like biology and chemistry, so I was offered a few degree for full scholarship. And since I like biology, so I thought as well just do biomedical science. Yeah, so I did biomedical science, and when I was studying, my lecturer asked me to conduct peer-to-peer session for my junior to teach them on subject that I've taken before, and I find great joy in teaching them. And then also when I was in Taylor's, so Teach for Malaysia, they have this TFM champion. So one of my friends who were the champion for Teach for Malaysia, she actually reached out to me and say, hey, I think you are Teach for Malaysia fellow material. She asked me to check out Teach for Malaysia, and then she asked me to attend the session conducted by Teach for Malaysia in our school. That time it was called Teh Tarik session. I didn't put much thought into becoming a teacher then, because I was studying biomedical science and I was doing research. So I continue to work in a research line. I work for Cancer Research Malaysia. I was with my bioscience school as their research assistant for a while, and I was enjoying it in the beginning. And then after half a year doing research, I asked myself again, what have I contributed to the community? And I don't know the answer. So I started to feel that research is not for me, because I want to see more immediate impact in the community. So I go and interview other research scientists like my supervisor, the CEO, the doctors that have been doing research for more than 5 years. I ask them why do they stay in research, and their answer are not what I want for myself. Yeah, so I decided that I should leave before it is too late, before there's no turning back. Suddenly I remember about Teach for Malaysia that time, so I applied for Teach for Malaysia.
I got selected, and then I got posted to teach in Pasir Kudang, Johor for 2 years, and that was the most fulfilling time in my life. So for your information, because I come from not very well-to-do family, so I actually started working since I was 14 years old illegally. So I've actually experienced many types of job in my life, like being a office assistant, tuition center assistant, being a promoter, being an event labor, waitress, and being a teacher. By far is the most rewarding career for me. I actually didn't want to stop being a teacher because I really like my profession. But I stopped. I decided to stop. Oh, I'm sorry, but I'm just thinking of the right words to say. Because there was a delay in our placement, so after the 2 years contract, we need to reapply back to remain in the system. But that time, I don't know what other complication issue that the government was facing. After 3 months, we were still not posted back to school. And coming from a background who struggled financially, I just couldn't wait any longer. And actually, ever since the delay, like I know Project ID needs people to support, so I connected with Kelvin and I started working with Project ID since January. It's a short-term, full-time staff. Then he offered me to stay in Project ID after he know that there was delay in our placement. I really believe in student empowerment. I really believe in developing the next generation. And I really believe in helping someone to reach their fullest potential. And I'm also a strong believer that everyone has their own strengths and weaknesses. And our education system do not allow everyone to see that, because we only measure intelligence based on how well you score in exam. So that is why I'm with Treasure ID, to help people to see their strength, to help people develop their skills and the mindset needed to be successful. I don't think success equals to being able to score in your academy. Yes, because not many students enjoy learning in class. Every student has different preferences in learning, and I feel that education, we should adapt the way we teach according to the students' need. I think that is the essence of being a teacher. But it's all